Hi, my name's Emily and I'm a marine biologist. We do lots of different things. I particularly look at marine animals and see how we can try help them with climate change. Climate change is going to increase the temperature of the oceans, and it's also going to make it more acidic, like a lemon. Over time, this will impact how animals respond. So my job is to look at whether they can survive and then what we can do to try help them. So ocean acidification is something that I'm particularly passionate about. So acidification is where the pH starts to go low, and this can be incredibly detrimental to different marine animals. So this kit will go from purple to yellow. Purple is higher pH. If you think of baking soda, it's a really high pH. It goes then to yellow, which is very acidic, thinking more about lemons. So an easy way to do this is to blow and bubble into water. This will show us what is actually happening when we put more carbon dioxide in the atmosphere because of, say, using cars and things like that. And this will have a big consequence for different marine animals.
I spend about 80% of my time in the laboratory. I then go and spend some time in our aquarium where we house some of the animals. And then the rest of the time is in the field doing field work.
So I am looking at how the DNA changes with climate change. And so these dyes pick up DNA. And what it does is it amplifies different genes to a level where we can detect it on a machine. I wanted to be a marine biologist since I was about 5 years old. And I saw some crabs on the beach and I decided that I wanted to help them. So after I left high school, I spent 3 years doing my undergraduate degrees in marine science and zoology. I then went and completed my master's in zoology and marine science. I then went and completed my PhD at Auckland University, which took 4 years. You do need a qualification to be a marine biologist. So if you want to work a lot on boats or you want to work as technicians, a master's is where it's at. If you want to be more of an academic and more in the policy realm, then I would recommend doing your PhD. My advice for anyone who's in high school and wants to pursue marine biology is to remain passionate. Being passionate about the marine life is the most important thing you can have.